if you think about being a lemming, it's a really risky business. That is, you are exposed to being eaten by weasels, stoats, birds of prey, so all kinds of animals that want to eat you. But under the snow, you are in a way protected from most of these predators. If they go on the top of the snow, they will be eaten by snowy owl or other birds of prey. So they really try to keep close to the vegetation on the ground, and that's what they eat also, so that's what they need. And then they need to be able to dig through the snow. And as soon as the snow gets a bit compact, they are going to spend too much energy to try to dig these tunnels under the snow, and then they will starve because they don't manage to get enough food to compensate for this extra energy they need to dig in the snow. For lemmings, when they are under the snow, what is best is really when you have a cold, dry winter, because then you get this layer close to the ground with dry snow that lemmings can dig through. What is bad for lemmings is when you have this wet, mild winter, because then the snow gets quite compact, quite hard. You can even get ice. That's the worst case scenario. And if you get ice on the ground, then the lemmings cannot feed, and they cannot reproduce, and then the populations collapse. A good winter is really a winter which is dry and cold. And when we have had this kind of dry and cold winters, then we have really large increases in the lemming populations. Lemmings are very important because of these huge fluctuations in abundance. And especially when you have high densities of lemmings, one should realize that when we speak about high densities, it means you can have 50 or 100 lemmings per hectare. And now we are talking about relatively low productive system. The tundra is not a system where the biomass and the productivity of the vegetation is very high. So when you have 50 or 100 lemmings per hectare, and by 100 by 100 meters, that's a lot of animals. And they are important both in terms of what they eat, that is, especially during the winter, they will really graze down the vegetation. And they are also important in terms of what eat the lemmings, that is, all the predators. And there are many species that are really dependent on lemmings, like the snowy owl, so the white owl, and you have also the Arctic fox and so on. And these species, in fact, can reproduce only when the lemmings are abundant enough. So if you don't have lemmings, you miss this effect on the vegetation, this grazing effect they have during the winter, and you miss also all the predators that depend on the lemmings. So you get quite different ecosystems if you, in a way, the lemmings disappear. Lemmings usually have these peaks. They are regular. That is, they happen every 3, 4, or 5 years, depending on where you are, for example, in Norway. In the south, they are more every 3 years. In the north, they are more every 4 or 5 years. And what we know from our observations, so what we have been doing in the field, and also from previous more anecdotal observations, is that there have been periods with peaks. For example, we have had some large peaks in 2007 and 2011. But then we have had, for example, in 2015, we had no lemming. We had a peak for the small rodents, so the voles, but no lemming.